mama's clothes. At least for where that I suppose it goes. Somewhere in the world tonight, before she reaches to turn out the light, she'll be praying from a tender heart, a simple prayer. That's a work of art, and I don't even know her name, but I'm praying for her just the same, that the Lord will write his name upon her heart. 'Cause somewhere in the course of this life, a little boy will need a godly wife. So hold on to Jesus, baby, wherever you are. Somewhere in the world out there, that little girl is learning how to care. She's picking up her mama's charms, or maybe
game. have nothing but this empty heart of mine. When I needed inspiration, when the night was all I knew, you were the light shining into my life, the reason for all the love I'm feeling. Now that I found you, I don't know how I live without you. I don't know how I survive without your love. Now that I found you, I only know I'd be lost without you. I found my love, I'll never find again. Cause all I ever needed and all I ever wanted has come true.
Treasure of a lifetime, the love inside your eyes. When I reach for inspiration, in your touch it's always there, giving me faith every step of the way, giving me all I ever needed. Now that I found you, I don't know how I live.
This is the Baptist High School students where I teach. These are my friends. They're going to help me ask you something now, Teresa. Teresa?
Will you marry me?
Congratulations. Can I come to the wedding?
I've got to talk louder so the camera can hear me. I love you with all my heart. And I want to spend the rest of my life with you. That is beautiful. God has given you to me as a special gift.
I wanna have you here. Let's just get one nice picture. Gentlemen, just get right in there, good and close to pastor. We need to smile right out of here. You got it. Looks good. Excellent. Okay, we need a couple of our grooming best man here. Get the wax out of his ears. Just get him all straightened out. There you go. All right, good deal. Maybe just a handshake between you two guys. Great. You want to look right out here at me again? Great. Good job, gentlemen. Oh, we didn't flash. Hang on. Give it a little boost here. Trying to milk this battery for all it's worth. Okay, looks good. One more time. Great. All right. Great. Let's do one of you crying on his shoulder here. Put your hand up on there and put your head down on your hand and pat him on the back. Tell him it'll be all right. It'll be fine. Okay. Thank you.
Good afternoon. On behalf of Greg and Teresa, I'd like to welcome you to this very, very special occasion. Greg and Teresa would like to thank you for sharing this very special day with them, for witnessing their vows of love to begin their new life together today. And so many of you, their friends and family, especially those of you who have come from such great distances, could be here. It means a great deal. It is their prayer that Christ will be honored and glorified, not just today, but for the rest of their lives. They want Him to be the head of their home and the Lord of all that they do. It is their prayer that He will also bless your lives, as He has theirs, through your generosity, love, and friendship. We would also like to express their sincere gratitude and love to their moms and dads for the guidance and direction they have given them, the wonderful memories that they have shared together, the wisdom that's been shared and taught throughout the years, and the patience that only a parent can possess. That can never fully be repaid. They've looked forward to this day for all of their lives. They've prayed about who it would be that they would stand at this altar next to. And they stand here today believing that it is God and God alone who's brought them together. Let's pray together, shall we? Father, we come before you this morning with a great sense of gratitude and expectation as we look forward to what lies before us this day. The marriage ceremony of Greg and Teresa, for the fact that we can look back at their lives and see how specifically you have worked to bring them together. To know that it is because of you that they're standing here today, ready to pledge their lives to each other. We ask that you would direct today and all that transpires, for we know that marriage is a gift from you. We ask that it is your name and your name only today that would be lifted up, and that would be honored, and would be glorified and praised. Thank you for these two young people, for the lives that they have lived to this point, for the way that you have worked to bring them together from this point on. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. You may be seated. Pastor Bishop and I kind of put a little trick on Greg and Teresa. We'd like to take a few moments, each of us, he'll do it in a few moments, and I will at this point, to walk down memory lane. Pastor Bishop, in a few moments, will reminisce a little bit with Greg about what it was like when Greg was in his youth group. And I'm going to take just a few moments and remember with Teresa some of the places that we've been together. We'll laugh and maybe cry a little bit, but it's been exciting. No crying, she says. It'll be exciting to see what God has done. Teresa, my very first memory of you was your expectation of going to teen missions. The summer you were looking forward to spending in Europe. Then as we prepared the next summer to go to Quebec and spend the summer up there working with those people and having the opportunity to be with your brother. I remember our trip to New York. We lived in a trailer together, five or six of us. And Teresa wanted to be the cook one evening. And we were going to have garlic bread. And it caught on fire. And we had a great time laughing about that over the years. Teresa has always impressed me, as she has those who have known her, by her ingenuity and creativity. It was on that trip that she decided we should all look alike, the girls should. And she decided that the girls needed to wear skirts that were the same. And she undertook the endeavor of sewing them, helping those who knew how to sew to do it, and those who didn't to be creative and help them learn. Remember a snow camp expedition that we took when the road was so icy that we couldn't travel by bus. We had to walk hand in hand from tree to tree to get to where we were supposed to be back in the woods. It was Teresa's spiritual sensitivity that took that experience and equated it to our spiritual lives and the importance of friendship and how we walk with friends through life. I remember the expectation of going to teen leadership as a camper, and then years later as a counselor, and watching what God has done in her life. Her and my wife have been very good friends over the years. They've walked probably 100 miles together. at all times of the day. They've shared many experiences. Teresa, I've always admired your creativity and ingenuity. I've always admired your spiritual sensitivity and the way that you were willing to allow God to direct your life. And as you stand here today, ready to commit your life to Greg, to serve the Lord, there is no greater joy in all of the world than I could ever have than to see what God has done in your life. Greg, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? Keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live.
I will.
Teresa, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holiest state of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live? Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
My mother and I do.
Thank you. any rainbows, or search this world to find my dream come true. And I don't need a lucky star to guide me. I found my treasure in you.
This time we would like to read a tribute to our parents. Teresa will read a tribute to her mom and dad, and I'd like to read a tribute to mine.
Well, here we are. The day which I've been looking forward to, and you've been dreading, has finally arrived. Right now I'm flooded with thoughts, emotions, and feelings. Today, I'm plunging into a new phase of my life, and you are as well. You see me standing here with Greg, and I'm glowing. You may feel as though you are fading into the shadows, but there are certain things you need to know. First, I am not leaving you behind, but taking a part of you with me. When I demonstrate manners, and when I make decisions based on biblical, moral values, when I show kindness to others, and love, and forgive unselfishly, when someday I get up for my children in the middle of the night, or sing them to sleep, I have you with me. When I enjoy a good meal, or write a creative poem, or savor the sunset on the beach, I remember you, Mom and Dad. You have put so much into molding and shaping me that I can never leave you behind.
Still freezes. As Greg and I learn to love one another through all of life's circumstances, I am sure I will discover even more fully the way you have loved me. What can I say to you? Thank you is so drastically insufficient. I want to throw my arms around your neck and tell you how much I love you. I cannot go back to my childhood and climb into your lap or curl up in your arms. I can go and give my life and love to Greg the way you've given it to me. Together we can live and love and teach our children. Mom and Dad, I know that no matter how far apart we are, you are still with me because you are a part of me. I will pass part of you on to my children to love and enjoy as long as I live. So I don't leave you now, but take you with me and pray that you know how much you are loved. It may sound like we will never see each other. However, I look forward to developing a new kind of relationship with you. Of course, I will always be your child, and you will always be my parents. But I hope that our friendship will grow and deepen during this next stage of life. Mom and Dad, this is the day maybe you thought would never arrive.
Amen.
You have seen me through my earliest stages of liking girls, through my past relationships and breakups. In all those times, you were always there, not to pressure or probe, but just to be there if needed. Dad, I can still remember after one breakup, I was out late at night walking by myself. When I got home, you were there, waiting for me on the porch. We didn't talk about it then, but I knew you were there for me and you cared. Mom, as I grew up watching you, I learned about the kind of woman that I would want to marry. You demonstrated loyalty and sacrificial love to Dad and to us, your children. You never boasted of all you had done or expressed complaint, but you continued working faithfully. I now see that I have chosen to marry a woman who has many of the same godly, loving characteristics that I've seen in you all these years. The thing I remember most that's contributed to my life is your love for the Lord and the desire to instill that in us. Although family devotions at 6 in the morning was not always popular, your steadfastness to what is important impacted me greatly. I can hardly remember a time when, after talking on the phone these last 9 years, you have not reminded me that you pray for me daily. Seeing you consistently pray as I was growing up, I have no doubt that you pray for me, and that is comforting and encouraging. Mom and Dad, the fact that God has brought Teresa into my life and us together today is due partially to the influence your prayers and example had on me. I pray God will help Teresa and I to be as faithful to each other and to Him as you have.
Psalm 145. I will exalt you, my God the King. I will praise your name forever and ever. Every day I will praise you and extol your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom. One generation will commend your works to another. They will tell of your mighty acts. They will speak of the glorious splendor of your majesty. And I will meditate on your wonderful works. They will tell of the power of your awesome works, and I will proclaim your great deeds. They will celebrate your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. The Lord is good to all. He has compassion on all he has made. All you have made will praise you, O Lord. Your saints will extol you. They will tell of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might, so that all men may know of your mighty acts and glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is faithful to all his promises and loving toward all he has made. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up all those who are bowed down. The eyes of all look to you and give them their food at the proper time. You open your hand and satisfy the desires of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and loving toward all he has made. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. He fulfills the desires of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. The Lord watches over all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth will speak in praise of the Lord. Let every creature praise his holy name forever and ever. Thank you.
You know where I've failed. My weakness has been unveiled. And yet it's by grace you choose to love and to forgive. So come what may, our home is here to stay. A witness to the lasting promise he has made. And God causes all things to grow through every season we go. He will guard the life that is planted in our souls. And when we
Saturday night, where you and Tim had a little difficulty, were very sick, and on the way to church that Sunday morning, driving the van, I had to prepare a message because I expected that you were Tim to handle that, but it ended up being both of you were sick that morning. So it's many experiences we had, and I remember also the fact that we got out on the tennis court, you were pretty gracious with me, and didn't beat me too bad, so I appreciated that as well. Always enjoyed the opportunity to chat with you. One special occasion that we had in the process of your senior trip with your senior class, we had the opportunity to take a walk. It was a long walk. Probably you two would be taking many of those, won't you? And remember that long walk that we had. We came back, and as a result of that time of discussion, we talked about a lot of things. We talked about goals. We talked about your life and ministry that you were looking forward to, and relationships with the opposite sex. All those things that were very important. In fact, by the time we finally got back, people wondered what had happened to us because we were gone so long. But that was a rich, rich time. And I always appreciated your openness and your involvement in that opportunity. Greg, you've really fulfilled your name. Your name means watchful. You've shown discernment and wisdom in many, many ways. And I'm sure that that's very evident to all those who know you well. That's a characteristic that you have. We appreciate that and enjoy that. Would also like to mention about the importance of your two lives together. Greg, Teresa, both of you have made a decision in your life to personally trust Jesus Christ as your Savior. You've taken the truth of what the Word of God has to say and personally applied it. That has to be the most important decision in your life. The evidence of the decisions and involvements that you've had in the past and the ambitions and directions that you will take in the future are directly related to that decision. Ephesians 2:8-9 clearly express that, for by grace are you saved through faith, that not of yourself, it's a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16. What a joy it is to be able to be involved here in a wedding of two Christians who personally know Jesus Christ as Savior. And I know it's your desire that if there be anybody here who would be interested to know about Jesus Christ as their Savior today or any time in the future, you would love to take the time in a written way, using the phone, or personally sitting down and taking the time to communicate personal faith in Jesus Christ. I know that's very, very important to you. I would love to do that with anyone. As comments here as well in your past dating relationship, Greg had shared with me your commitment that you had made. And establishing friendship as the means of your relationship throughout your dating times. I can't stress that, how valuable that is. I know many young people who have fallen and had struggles because they have not made that commitment. And you need to be commended for that commitment. You need to be held up as an example to others that they might faithfully follow through and carry that true in their life as well. And I want to commend you for your testimony of purity and coming to this day and being morally pure. That standard has been an extremely high one, an extremely valuable one, and one that I believe God is going to use in your, through your lives as a testimony to others. I want to just mention as well here the statement of the past, but you also are desirous of a standard for the future. You as a wedding party and you as witnesses here today need to be encouragement and a challenge to Greg and Teresa as husband and wife. This is not a one-day event. This is a lifelong commitment. And your standing here in their presence means that you're also making a commitment to them for the future, that you're going to hold them responsible for their lives and that they would maintain a godly standard. I want to encourage that you do that by maintaining six aspects that will be very important to them. This is a charge to them that you as witnesses and as a wedding party need to take personally as very, very important to you to be maintaining in your life and relationship with Greg and Teresa as well in the future. First of all, a desire for maturity. Maturity where you're unselfish and you're very giving, one to another and to others as well in your ministry and the future that you're looking forward to, as well in your relationship as husband and wife. Maturity is going to be absolutely essential. It's where you're going to be willing to be unselfish. And there's going to be many tests of that and many opportunities for you to demonstrate that with each other. That's something you need to continue to strive for. In 2 Peter chapter 1, it talks about adding to your faith, your salvation, your personal decision to know Christ as Savior, adding your faith virtue to virtue and the other qualities that are listed there, to be a demonstration to others that those desires in your life would be to continually grow in honor of the Lord. Secondly, the Bible clearly talks about marriage and the importance of submission. It's a holy estate. It's established by God and it needs to be carried out God's way. Genesis 3:16 says, thy desire shall be to thy husband and he shall rule over thee. Ephesians 5:22 through 24 says, wives, submit yourself unto your own husband as unto the Lord. For husband shall be the head of the wife, even as Christ is head of the church. And he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be subject unto their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for them. We recognize that God's standard there is a very high one. And it's one that we need to carry out in daily involvement in relationships, husband and wife. So maturity, submission, and thirdly, love. Love is an extremely important word. 1 Corinthians 13 needs to be one that you would review and practice and carry out in your life. That you allow the other to be centered upon and not yourself. Where you would be able to appreciate, approve, and accept others. That's an important quality that is continually in need of in our life. Fourthly, communication. We're in an age of poor listeners. A time where we are so important to communicate what we have desired to communicate rather than being good listeners. We need to share also in our involvements openly and making sure that we have no secrets and nothing that we hide. There's two things that will kill communication: explosion and tears. We need to be open and willing to communicate and to care for each other. There's two golden expressions when you consider communication: I'm sorry and I love you. Those demonstrations of communication and concern will carry you a long way and have a right relationship. Fifthly, prayer. Prayer is a vital, vital part of your relationship. It needs to be something that you're committed to together, that you would have a pattern and plan for that in your lives. And sixthly, Christ would be preeminent in your lives. You know, in your prayer life, in your spiritual life, as you're closer to the Lord, you will also be closer to each other, because God is fixed. And Christ being the center of your life, you're close to Him, you will be close to each other. That's a joy and anticipation for you as a couple to be charged with the importance of your relationship with each other and to maintain these six qualities and desire, and as a wedding partner and as witnesses to be faithfully carrying that out. At this time, I'd like for you to share your vows with each other. You'll join hands and communicate your vows to each other.
God, our family and friends, this is the covenant I make with you as we seek to honor God in our marriage. Teresa, as your husband, I will be committed to learning how to love you as myself and sacrificially as Christ has loved us. I will strive to treat you with kindness and honor as a special treasure. I will work to provide for you and take proper leadership in our home. I will desire to forgive and accept you, not allowing any differences to linger. I will work at communicating with you with all honesty and openness as your best friend. I will give myself to you and reserve my body for you alone. I will be content with the various circumstances of life that God places us in. I will be dedicated to pray for you and lead you in a closer relationship with God. I will enjoy the special blessings of our marriage until God takes one of us home to be with Him.
Before God, our family and friends, this is the covenant I make with you as we seek to honor God in our marriage. Greg, as your wife, I will be committed to loving you sacrificially the way Christ has loved us. I will strive to treat you with kindness, building you up both in private and in public. I will trust, honor, and respect you as the leader of our relationship. I will desire to forgive and accept you, not allowing our differences to linger. I will seek to remember that you are my treasured gift from God and enjoy the special blessings of being your best friend. I will give myself to you completely and reserve my body for you alone. I will be content in whatever circumstances in which God places us. I will stand by your side, dedicated to supporting you with prayer and encouragement. I will remain committed to my vows until the Lord takes one of us to be with himself.
The vows have just been made by Greg and Teresa and are a reality of a covenant. The word covenant, it comes from the root word, which means to bind. Your vows, the sacred covenant, solemnly bind your lives together until death shall part you. In the Bible, particularly in the Old Testament, there are various signs and symbols used to seal a covenant. Sometimes it was just a joining of hands or making oaths. Sometimes it was a heap of stones, a feast, a sacrifice. But whatever it was, it expressed the making and completion of a covenant. The symbol of your covenant will be with the rings. The ring, the circle of the ring, is an emblem of eternity, and the metal is a type of what is least tarnished and most enduring. It is to show how lasting and imperishable the faith that you mutually pledge to each other. Teresa, this ring is to be a ceaseless reminder of this wonderful hour and solemn vows that you have taken. To you, Greg, give this ring as a token of your love for Teresa. Will you, Teresa, take this ring as a token of Greg's love for you and wear it as a token of your love for him? Greg, this ring will be a ceaseless reminder of the wonderful hour and solemn vows that you are taking. Do you, Teresa, give this ring to Greg as a token of your love for him? Will you, Greg, take this ring as a token of Teresa's love for you, and will you wear it as a token of your love for her?
I will.
Then you are now devoted to each other until death parts you. We have a couple other symbols that are very, very important at the time of marriage. Ones that are used to remind us of the significance of our lives and relationship. The ceremony of the candles. The two outside candles of the center candelabra represents the lives of your life to this moment. You are two distinct lights, each capable of going their own separate ways. To bring bliss and happiness to your home, there must be a merging of these two lights into one light. This is what the Lord meant when he said, "On this accord, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall be one flesh." From now on, your thoughts shall be for each other rather than for your own selves individually. Your plans shall be mutual. Your joys, sorrows shall be shared alike. As you each take a candle together and light the center one, you'll be extinguishing your own candle and also letting the center candle represent the union of your lives into one flesh. As the one light cannot be divided, neither shall your lives be divided. But they will be united as a testimony for Christ in a Christian home and in the world. May the radiance of this one light be a testimony of your unity in the Lord Jesus Christ. For as much as you, Greg, and you, Teresa, have consented together in the holy wedlock, and have witnessed by the same before God and these people, and have given your pledge of your faithfulness to each other, and have declared the same in giving and receiving of rings, I pronounce that you are both, you are now husband and wife. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, let no man bring asunder. Make this your will. Thank you.
Let me say one time, maybe two, that I love the way that you love me, and I wish I knew more of you. Let me say once more that I love you. Let me say one time, maybe two, that I love the way that you love me, and I wish I knew.
Following the recessional, we'd like to have you all to please remain seated. The new bride and groom will be able to come back and let you go out, and they'll take you off the center aisle. And then there'll be an opportunity for you in the narthex to receive a map to be able to get to the reception that we'll be following. Let's close together in a word of prayer. Father, what a privilege it is to be able to be here for this occasion, to be part of the marriage ceremony here. For Greg and Teresa, for their future, we pray, Father, your best upon them. We thank you for their lives and their commitment to the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we ask, dear God, that you would lead them in the steps ahead, that you would draw them closer to you, and that their lives would be radiant testimonies and communicating the person of the Lord Jesus Christ wherever they go. Use them in their lives together in commitment to ministry, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm glad to present to you today, Greg, Mr. and Mrs. Greg Whiting.
Make your mind. really need Jamie. please grab your seats at this time for the introduction of the bridal party. First and foremost, the parents of the bride, Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Campagna. The parents of the groom, Mr. and Mrs. Dale Whiting. Now the rest of the bridal party have a few words by the bride and groom to be said about them. And as we're welcoming all of the participants, please stand. The first one of the bridal party is Amy Scott. Wait, before you come in, I have a few words to say, then and I will announce both of you, and then come in. So just stand there like good boys and girls. Okay, Amy, along with Teresa, graduated from elementary ed at Baptist Bible College. You'll hear that a number of times. So I'm going to say BBC, that means Baptist Bible College. She plans to teach second grade at Bethel Baptist Christian School in Cherry Hill. And what Teresa would like to, for Amy, you to know is, ever since we met in eighth grade, your love for the Lord has been a shining example and encouragement to me. Together we survived those boy crazy days, 4 years of college and summer camp of counseling. I will always treasure your friendship. Escorted by Amy is Jim DeWan. Jim is presently pursuing his Master of Theology degree at Baptist Bible Seminary. I'm gonna have to abbreviate that to BBS if we get more of those. Okay, he and his wife Colleen have a baby girl, Catherine. Greg would like to have you know is that my 1 year of living in the seminary dorm with you was a fun and growing experience I'll never forget. You are someone I know and I can share anything with and receive full support. Don't forget that you owe all of your knowledge of Greek and Hebrew to yours truly. Come on in. Since you all look kind of tired on your feet, you may be seated right now. The next we have Barb Woodard. Barb is the proud mother of Timmy and Taylor and is expecting her third child this October. Thought we couldn't tell, right? Barb, Teresa would like you to know that your impact on my life as a youth pastor's wife has been great. Thank you for getting me started as a speed walker and giving me advice on everything from diets and sewing to friendship and marriage. Barb is being escorted by Craig Brittingham. Craig recently graduated with his Master of Divinity degree from BBS. Y'all know what that is, right? Craig and his wife Missy have two boys, Joshua and Jordan. Craig, thank you for your love for the Lord and dedication to serving Him. It has been a great example for me. Thank you also for your friendship and counsel. God will use you greatly in ministry for Him. Next we have Joanne Bartolotta. Joanne is Teresa's older sister. She lives on Long Island with her husband Greg and her precious bundle of joy, Rachel. Joe, you have always been there for me to look up to. Your support, encouragement, and generosity are an inspiration to me. Our family would not have been the same without you. I love you. Joanne is being escorted by Dan Kruger. Dan and his wife Melissa are moving and will be soon teaching at North Florida Christian School in Tallahassee, Florida this fall. Dan, I enjoyed having you as one of my closest friends in college. Our basketball seasons and ministry opportunities together are special highlights for me. Thank you for encouraging me in our friendship and all that you've done for me. And Dan, thank you for letting me dunk over you all of those times. Next we have Christy Miller. Christy married to Jamie for almost a year, lives in Voorhees, New Jersey, and is preparing, getting ready for their first child in November. Christy, I'll never forget our memories driving to school, playing field hockey and softball together, and tanning during study halls. It's hard to believe that 4 years ago, I set you up with Jamie. Thanks for always standing by me and believing that someday Mr. Wright would come along. Christy is being escorted by Scott Benedict. Scott is currently a youth pastor in Florida. He and his wife Stephanie are both graduates of BBC in Pennsylvania. Scott, your friendship is highly valued tonight, and I'm thankful for the times we spent together. I take full credit for your marriage since I was present with you and Stephanie on your first date. The year we both played soccer at BBC is a special memory of mine. You owe all of your soccer skills to me, right? Next we have Wendy Payton. Wendy and Teresa were long-lost friends from junior high. Surprisingly reunited at BBC, they picked up their friendship from where it left off. Wendy is now living in Michigan. Wendy, whenever I needed to chat or to have tea or cheat on my diet, you were always there for me. Thanks for your honesty, generosity, and your thoughtfulness. I've really missed you these past 2 years. Wendy is being escorted by Mike Newton. Mike works presently in construction, and he resides in the country of Idaho. For those budding geography majors, Idaho is in the United States. Mike, beginning in high school, I've appreciated our fun times together and your unconditional support for me and all that I've done. God has given you a soft heart and a musical ability to use for Him. I'll call you Colette. Next is Jessica Mejia. Jessica is Teresa's niece. She will be going into seventh grade this fall. She was recently baptized and enjoys reading, drawing, and youth group activities. Jess, I pray that you will continue to grow closer to our Lord. Thank you for thinking of writing to me often while I was at college. I love you. Next we have Judy Woodall. Judy just graduated from the elementary education at BBC. On May 21st, Teresa stood as her maid of honor when she married Andy. Jules, my kindred spirit, I couldn't imagine surviving college without you. All of our walks, share times, prayers, and bagel runs have given me the privilege of developing a friendship that would really last a lifetime. Julie is being escorted by Dave Whiting. David is the best man and brother of the groom. He is a youth pastor at Baptist Bible Church in Shiresmantown, Pennsylvania. He and his wife, Sue, are expecting their first child in November. Dave, I'm thankful to have you as my brother. My memories of our childhood together will last forever. Dave, thank you for losing to me everything and making me an expecting uncle. I love him. For the little ones? We have Julie Crothy. She is the flower girl. Julie is the 3-year-old niece of Teresa. She is being escorted by Joshua Brittingham, the ring bearer. Joshua is the 5-year-old son of Craig, one of the grooms. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we have been waiting for, the first time in public. Please. please rise and give a round of great welcome to the new Mr. and Mrs. Gregory Whiting. There are a couple of announcements. One, if you haven't signed the guest book out by the front or the autographed picture, please do so at some point during the meal. For a married couple, for the new married couple, what we can do is have a couple go right in front of the bridal party table and kind of demonstrate how it's done. Once that takes place, we hope that Greg and Teresa will follow in suit. There is another way. Now this, you do not have to have any talent in this area at all. And I will be one of the participants, but what each person can do, if they desire, at their table, can group together and say, hey, listen, we're gonna come up with a song that has the word love in it. In order for to get Greg and Teresa to kiss, that whole party at a table must sing a song with the word love in it. Everybody okay with that? Say yes.
Yes.
And every time the word love is mentioned in the song, Greg and Teresa will partake. Okay? If anybody does have any announcements that they would like to have broadcasted, let me know and I'll do that. At this time, let's have a word of prayer for our food. Lord, we just thank you for this wonderful occasion, this beautiful day you've given us, and the wonderful celebration of Greg and Teresa's wedding. We thank you for bringing each and every one here safely. We thank you that you are in control of their lives and have a wonderful plan for it, Lord. We just thank you now for this food. We ask you to bless it through the nourishing, strengthening, healing, and wholeness of our bodies. We give you this day. Thank you for it. In your name we pray. Amen. Please be seated, and our host will be coming around shortly.
Love is all you need. 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 Love is all you
say something to Greg and Teresa?
Well, God bless you. You have lots of kids. That's about love.
Good luck.
Anything, Pastor Ting?
Hi.
Say,
Greg, congratulations. We love you. We're very happy for you. Congratulations, you guys. Have fun on your honeymoon.
Thanks. Okay, you guys want to say something to him? Yes, now.
Yeah, like
that's what
now.
This little red light indicates.
No,
this is on.
Not ready?
No, I'm ready. The kid's running. Go.
Because they read it.
You gotta speak up.
Teresa, Barb just told me that if you have any questions, she'll feel free to cancel you in any industry. I don't know how they can, any area. But congratulations, guys. I wish you the best. Just relax and enjoy your honeymoon.
Great. Go for it.
Greg and Teresa, I just want to say thank you for having me in your wedding. I love you guys, and I know that you're going to have the happiest of homes. And I just was so impressed with the wedding. All the creativity that went into it was far beyond what I even knew. I know you're going to have a great time on your honeymoon. Thanks, and praise the Lord that you're going into ministry, because that's where you should be. I just love you guys to no end. I hope you're going to write us and keep in touch. Greg, I want to be in your prayer chain. I want you to get in touch with me. Keep in touch with me. Let's stay friends forever. God bless you. Thanks.
All right.
I wish you much love and happiness from the Biancos, and have a lovely time with your life.
Thanks. All right, you got to speak up, though.
Yeah.
Real hand.
Congratulations, Teresa. We wish you the best of luck, you and Greg. We look forward to hearing what God's going to do in your life the next few years.
All right.
Keep going, Steve.
Okay, you guys want to say something to them?
We're so happy. You ready?
Yeah, go for it.
We're so happy for you, Teresa.
Thanks for inviting us to your celebration.
Yeah, how about over here? Girlie!
Oh, what am I supposed to say? What's up, Mr. Reese and Greg?
Well, you're not talking to me. This isn't my wedding. That was 3 months ago.
Oh, gosh. I'm still in shock, Teresa. I can't believe it. I've been married. Best of luck, and you'll both be in my prayers.
Great.
Congratulations. My name's Matt. If you never see me again, I'm having a great time, and thank you very much.
Great.
Hi, Teresa. I remember you with Jamie and Nick and the kids and seeing up at BBC, and it's really good to see you and come to your wedding and watch you get married and start a new life and taking off to Connecticut.
Santiago.
Say something, Teresa.
I love you, Teresa.
Joy's a spokesman here.
I'm the spokesman. Teresa, this has been a beautiful wedding, a beautiful afternoon, and we just wish you and Greg all the best. We love you both.
Teresa and Gregory, we want to wish you the best, much happiness, and lots of love, and good health.
Good luck in your marriage and your new life together.
Teresa and Greg, I wish you all the happiness in the world, and I hope that you will always be as happy as you are today.
Ma, you gotta talk louder. Good luck, guys. We love you.
He's like a perfect match. They seem finally attuned to each other, and I think they'll find happiness in everything they desire in their entire life.
Now that you're close to New Hampshire, last long drive.
That's right. That's cool.
Yeah, she's in Connecticut now. So you can come and see us, because you have no excuses this time. You can't find a piece of chocolate in there, you can come see us. And bring your wedding album. Love you.
What? This is the kids.
No.
We wish Teresa and Greg a wonderful life together. And they had a wonderful, beautiful ceremony. Are you doing this?
You gotta talk loud.
Oh. It's on, Mom.
Yeah, it's on. I got all that.
It's on.
Okay, great. Uncle Tom, do you want to say anything?
No, not much. We always invited you and your wife to come up to visit us anytime. Even when I'm not there.
Thanks.
Congratulations and best of wishes. You better watch out, you'll end up with a bunch of little ones like this.
I just want to wish Greg and Teresa a lot of happiness. This is a really fun wedding.
Just a few years, and hear a little bit about some of the history of Greg and Teresa. And it starts back in the summer of 1986. Greg was now a sophomore at BBC and was traveling with a basketball ministry team called the Defender Five. Teresa was now a freshman in high school and attending a week of basketball camp at her church. They first met here, but it wouldn't be 5 years until a relationship and friendship developed. Greg grew up with his brother and sister in Des Moines, Iowa. Is that a country?
God's country.
God's country, that's right. His brother David is 2 years younger, but he beat Greg to it. He was married 3 years ago, this Tuesday, to Sue. He will now come and say a few words. Come on, Dave.
thought it would be appropriate to write a poem. To my older brother Greg, who's just recently been wed, as a relief to all, I do, she actually said. I'm your younger brother, and advice to me you usually give. This time listen close, so happily ever after you might live. Where should I begin? Oh, let me see. I'll start with tonight. It's a crucial key. This evening, don't swivel into bed, turn your back and curl up on one side. For now, my big brother, you have a new bride. So if you get to the hotel tonight and you don't know what to do, just call your little brother. The number, 975-8412. Now, when it comes to the reality of everyday life, let me give you some tips on avoiding some marital strife. She's the love of your life, some would say your main squeeze. Always be polite, saying thank you and please. Be loving, be gentle, be patient, be kind, even when she gives you a piece of her mind. Put down the toilet seat, hang up your pants. Help with the dishes whenever you get the chance. When you do the wash, separate the darks from the whites. Believe me, this can cause some terrible fights. She'll love you the most if you help with the chores. Oh, Teresa, did I mention he snores? Greg, no matter what she cooks, make sure you try it. Well, no, she does well if you end up on a diet. Although for years together you've made me laugh and cry, today you've made me proud. You've got a great bride. Today you've covenanted together, you and your wife, to love each other always in all avenues of life. Through such a godly couple, what God won't do, he certainly delights in one such like you. Know that all of us will love you forever. May God bless you and keep you as you serve him together.
That was great. Excellent. Okay, as we continue, Teresa grew up the youngest of six children. Her parents understand that they are now losing their little baby. Teresa would like her father to join her now on stage. Dad, come on up. Now he was hoping to get the opportunity to dance with his daughter at a wedding. When he found out that there was no dancing, he was kind of disappointed. However, there will be one dance, and here it is. Teresa's prepared a little slide presentation for this special occasion.
I got some tissue.
Your spies, your hand, and your face. Daddy's little girl. Teresa grew... Well, no, I said that already. Okay, the story continues. While Greg was on his seminary internship in 1992, he began thinking about Teresa. When she went to BBC in 90, Greg was in his first year of seminary. They got to know each other a little bit through other friends, but they have never really spent time together until Greg graduated in 1992 from the seminary. When he came out for graduation, they went out for the first time on April 28, 1992, from 5 o'clock p.m. to 10:30 p.m. Ballpark. They say they saw each other every day for almost 2 weeks. They parted for the summer but kept in touch. Although there were no ties at that time, God led Greg back to BBC to teach at their Baptist high school that fall. They continued their friendship and dating. When Teresa took Greg home to meet her family for the first time, he met many of them because of a birthday celebration. He was a little surprised. He was not accustomed to being kissed by everyone he met. But that's kind of the Italian way. In their relationship, they were very careful in their physical relationship. In fact, at first, because Greg didn't really show all that much affection, Teresa's dad was wondering whether or not she was going to get that need met. But would she get enough of it? Well, for quite a while, the first question Teresa was asked by her family members was, well, did he kiss you yet? Teresa's dad and helpers will now come and lip sync the song, Kiss the Girl.
Kiss the girl.